back to the news, Wednesday, 5th of August, 2020. We've moved our crypto news from Tuesday to Wednesday this week, and today we're talking BTC, or Bitcoin, as investors flocking to Bitcoin as an inflation hedge. Normally that's in the territory of gold, but it's great to see Bitcoin working in this area too. Bitcoin's price surge has triggered a retail trading boom with exchanges around the world reporting record high Bitcoin trading volume, and one cryptocurrency hedge fund chief executive saying fear of missing out, sometimes known as FOMO, is drawing people in who are late to the party. In cryptocurrency, we often see momentum plays, said Joe DiPasquale, the CEO of crypto hedge fund Bitbull Capital. Bitcoin is currently in a breakout phase, just as it was in the first 6 months of 2019, when it increased its value by 189%, DiPasquale added, pointing to growing interest in Bitcoin from Wall Street and among payment firms. DiPasquale anticipates the Bitcoin price to hit $15,000, that's US, before the end of the year, which would put Bitcoin within touching distance of its $20,000 all-time high. Bitcoin climbed to around $20,000 in late 2017 before crashing back to around $3,000 a year later, with its huge retail investor-led rally fueled by an explosion of media interest in Bitcoin and its underlying blockchain technology. Bitcoin's sudden jump high this week resulted in a rush of traffic to Bitcoin exchanges as eager investors attempted to catch the upswing, invoking memories of the 2017 Bitcoin gold rush. Coinbase, the largest US Bitcoin and cryptocurrency exchange with 35 million users around the world, has seen a threefold increase in Bitcoin trading volume this week alone. Meanwhile, Binance US, a 10-month-old American arm of Binance, the world's largest cryptocurrency exchange by volume, reported Bitcoin trading this week hit an all-time high on its platform as well. Elsewhere, smaller Bitcoin companies have also seen a surge of interest. This week blew away anything we've seen, Corey Clipston, tech investor and founder of Bitcoin buying app Swan Bitcoin, said via Telegram, adding the four-month-old startup did about a third of our all-time revenue in just 5 days. However, Clipston doesn't think we're back at FOMO stage yet, although he concedes the expectations of so many Bitcoin investors that were in the early stages of another meteoric rise may be self-fulfilling. Like many Bitcoin price watchers, Clipston sees Bitcoin's cut to supply in May, when the number of new Bitcoin coming into the market was halved, coupled with the US Federal Reserve's massive stimulus measures in the wake of coronavirus-induced lockdowns, as bullish for Bitcoin price and causing a price spike for all hard assets. Of course, including gold, which came within striking distance of hitting $2,000 for the first time this last week. And an update there, it actually did punch through $2,000 last night. It was currently trading at around $2,020 per ounce. Clipston is echoed by analyst Thomas Kuhn of Quantum Economics. We are seeing volatility creeping back into the Bitcoin market, and there is a question whether it will attract the attention of Robin Hood momentum traders. But too early to tell if we have seen or if we will see FOMO yet, Kuhn said, pointing to the recent interest in stocks and shares from casual day traders who have been using low-cost trading apps such as Robinhood to pile into equity markets. In addition, Montreal-based Bitcoin buying service ShakePay has this week reported a significant surge in demand. Over the last few months, and particularly during the last few weeks, we've seen a significant surge in customer registrations and activity on our platform, ShakePay Chief Executive Jean Amouni said. As the Bank of Canada continues to print money, Bitcoin purchases and sales on ShakePay have been growing exponentially, and as of this month, we've broken over $400 million in digital currency bought and sold. As more investors look to digital gold as an inflation hedge in an increasingly digitalized world amidst unprecedented government money printing, we know it won't take much of an institutional allocation until $50,000 Bitcoin is back on the table. The Fed already has taken monetary policy to a new level that is extraordinary this year, pumping nearly $3 trillion of freshly created money into financial markets earlier and pushing its total assets to about $7 trillion. A growing number of investors in both digital asset and traditional markets believe the flood of dollars could whittle down the US currency's purchasing power. The dollar index, a gauge of the currency's strength in foreign exchange markets, fell 4% in July, the biggest monthly drop since 2010. Bank of America analysts wrote Monday in a report that's becoming a popular trade to bet against the dollar since investors are worried about the long-term impact of the rapid accumulation of US debt for the US dollar's reserve currency status. As gold, silver, equities, and long bonds reach record high levels and the US dollar slumps, the king of cryptocurrencies may be back in the spotlight for the foreseeable future. Jeff Dorman, a chief investment officer of the cryptocurrency-focused firm Arca, wrote Monday in a weekly blog, signaling that we might be only at the start of the current bull run. The Fed's extra loosening of monetary policy could help support prices for Bitcoin. Bitcoin prices have already soared 58% this year, beating silver's 36% and gold's 30%, not to mention the 2% gain in the S&P 500. Let's check out this next chart here to finish up with, showing Bitcoin as a clear winner since around, when did it start? March, looks like things have really kicked off for Bitcoin. Similarly for gold and silver. And the S&P is just dribbling along there. Well, that's news for today. Remember to visit ainsleybullion.com.au for all things gold and silver. Ainsley Wealth for everything cryptocurrency. And if you haven't yet checked it out, please go and check out our own cryptocurrency that we backed against real gold and real silver, which is the goldsilverstandard.com. So we've got a gold standard and the silver standard, two tokens. They're both available for purchase through Ainsley Wealth. Also available for purchase now at CoinSpot. We'll catch you tomorrow.